Hi everyone! Today I'm going to show you how to use the official Raspberry Pi SD card imager. This is the official and recommended way by the Raspberry Pi Foundation to flash SD cards, and probably also the easiest way to do this. This program will work with Windows, Mac or Ubuntu. So let's get started. To download the installer, simply head over to raspberrypi.org/downloads. I will leave all the links in the video description. Now, since I'm on a MacBook, I will download the macOS version, but installation for other platforms should be similar. Once the DMG file is downloaded, we open it and simply install it. The coolest part of the imager is that it will automatically download the image we want to burn to the SD card. So you don't need to manually download all the ISO files anymore. Of course, it is still possible to download and select any other ISO file. Here we have a list of different options and utilities. On top of the list, we have the standard Raspbian images and a few variants like the light version. I'm not going through the whole list since it is changing with almost every update of the imager. But it's good to know that many of the popular distributions are listed inside of this tool. At the bottom we have the SD card formatting utility and the option to choose any other ISO image that you might have downloaded. For this demonstration I will be selecting the light version of Raspbian since it's the fastest image to download and install. Many people don't know this, but there is an advanced configuration screen where we can configure some settings that will be applied when burning the image. To access this menu simply use the keyboard shortcut CTRL SHIFT X or Command SHIFT X. Here we can choose if we want the settings to be applied for only our current session, which means if we close the tool then the settings will be reverted, or if we want this to be our default settings. Here we can, for example, disable the overscan, change the host name, enable SSH and configure the password and keys for the Pi user, configure the Wi-Fi and locale settings, and finally, we have a few general settings for the imager itself. Next, we choose our SD card we want to use. Be careful to select the right card if you have multiple mass storage devices connected to your PC. The last thing you want to do is overwrite your SD card with your family pictures or top secret documents on it. Finally, double check our selection and press the right button. Confirm our selection and now wait for the process to complete. After the image is downloaded and burned with the SD card, the imager will automatically run a verification check on the SD card. This takes a few minutes. If you're in a hurry, you can cancel the verification. However, I do recommend you to let the imager finish the check, since you will lose much more time figuring out why your OS isn't working properly, compared to letting the check finalize. Once the flashing is completed, you will get a prompt that it's safe to remove the SD card. So once that's done, you can pop the SD card into your Raspberry Pi and start using it. That's it for this video. I really appreciate you watching, and if you did enjoy this video, please consider subscribing and liking this video. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comments and I will reply to you as soon as possible. I will also leave all the links in the video description so you can quickly download this tool as well. Once again, thanks for watching, and catch you guys next time.